Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Rapid Bites. Today I'm here with Isaac. Thanks, Isaac, for joining us today.
Thank you.
Yeah, and he's going to talk to us about request signatures. Before he does get started, I just want to take a quick reminder and let you know that we have a community, community.rapid.net. You can always go and ask questions, get answers, just talk about fintech. We also have our documentations at docs.rapid.net. Isaac will talk a little bit about that and show some of the inner workings of that in his demo today on the request signatures. So that said, we'll just get right into it. Thanks, Isaac, again, and I'll turn it over to you.
Awesome. Thank you, Drew. As you're saying, we are gonna show how to actually generate the signatures to make the request to our APIs. So I'm showing here in my screen the documentation. If you go to our reference guide, you will see here the message security section right here, and you'll find the request signatures documentation. So here you can find everything, but basically the signature is a pretty straightforward topic. It's not very difficult. It's just a formula. So this is the formula that we are showing here. And we're giving you the formula. You just have to concatenate several parameters that will be part of the request, the HTTP method, URL, salt timestamp, the access secret keys that you'll find in the client portal, and the body string when it's a POST request. So this is the formula. You just have to hash it, and that's it pretty much. You can read a little bit more about the different parameters here if you want. We already have a really good example. If you go to the code samples section, you will see some examples that we already have. You just can copy and paste this in your code and that's pretty much everything. We have something for .NET, JavaScript, PHP, Python. And in this case, I'm going to show you how to do it in Node.js. So I have a very simple Node.js application here. I just have a main application file, and I'm using Express just to show the responses of the API in the browser. You don't need to do that. I have two. I create here two URLs, a country URL and a payment URL. Basically, we're just gonna display the result or the responses of the API here, right? So let me try to run. And in this case, by the way, we're gonna use a library called Crypto.js. So if you do. You do need to install this. So you just type npm install and the name of the library, crypto.js, -js, and that's it pretty much you have to do before you can actually use this code. Let me just run this. Let me show you in the browser how this looks like. So I said we were gonna have a country URL. And basically I'm just passing a test JSON, which is this list payment methods. And we're also gonna have a payment URL. Make a payment, which is this other part we have here, right? So as I was saying, we have an example here. So let's just copy this example, but not for .NET, but for JavaScript. Just gonna copy it. I'm gonna create a new file. I'm gonna call it utilities.js, something like that. I'm gonna paste it, and this is pretty much the code that we have. You will need to use the access key, secret keys. Probably in production, you might want to use environment variables, not instead of just putting the keys here in the code, right? But for this example, I'm just gonna do it like this. And here in this code, we have a couple of functions that are important. We have a make request function, which we will use in our application. and we are passing the HTTP method, the URL, and the body, and we will use these parameters in the formula, right? That I just showed you before. Of course, these parameters will be sent in the headers of the API request. So we are passing, again, the HTTP method, the paths, and also a salt that you will generate here. It will be a random string, and you will send that salt to Rapid also, so that we can actually regenerate your signature and authenticate your request. We're gonna have an item potency key, and this is only relevant for payment, the payment endpoint when you create a payment, to tell Rapid, don't charge for this several times because it's the same payment. So if you want to make sure you are generating a payment for one single transaction, even though your application makes several attempts to charge that for that payment, if it's the same transaction, you can generate one single key and pass it to Rapid, and Rapid will know that it's only one transaction. We don't process the payment several times. And this is how you can control it. You pass it in the header as well, in the HTTP headers for the request. In this case, I'm just generating a new key every time. So in my example, I won't control that, but you can if you need to. And then the other function is the signature function, which is we are calling it here. But the definition is in fact down below, and here you can see that the formula is actually right here, right? So nothing really fancy. It's just a concatenation of these parameters, and then using the crypto library to hash this string, and basically that will be the formula. You will have to send us this signature in the headers so that we can recalculate the signature and then authenticate the API call. So that's how it works. Okay, so let me just grab then my access key and my secret keys, which are here in my client portal, right? You don't have an account, you can create it. It's pretty simple and free. I'm just making sure I am in the sandbox environment by toggling this button. So now I'm in sandbox. I go to the developers section, and I'm going to show here the keys. I'm just gonna delete this account after we record this video, but for now I'm just gonna copy this secret key. Oops. I'm gonna paste it. Here in the code. Okay, then the access key. I'm gonna paste it here. I'm gonna save. I think that's pretty much everything I need to do with this file. Now let's try to actually make the requests. And so I'm saying here we need to list the payment methods for a given country. So let's go check the documentation to do that. And again, in the API reference guide, you will find this documentation. There is a collect section because we are processing payments. So with our collect platform, you will find the payment method type object. And in this object is this is the endpoint. So basically you need to target this endpoint, and you need to pass the country code to actually list the payment methods that you can use in that specific country, right? So that's what we're gonna do. We have again some code here. So if I click the JavaScript section, and I will basically copy this code. In this case, I don't need the whole thing because the example has a function here. We already have a function, which is the endpoint, the URL that we programmed. So I'm just copying here this part, and I'm gonna paste it here. the country URL. I'm just gonna command the first JSON that we sent as an example, and I'm gonna just copy this. Let's see, we are making the request. We're using this utilities function. We're making the request to the payment methods, and we are just passing the country code. And we should see, or we should get the payment methods available in Italy, right? That's what we're trying to do. So instead of logging to the console, I'm just going to print that in the browser. I'm just gonna say res.json. I'm gonna pass the result. I'm gonna do the same in case there is an error. I'm gonna say res.json, and I'm gonna just pass the JSON with the errors. Don't need that text. I'm gonna save. The other thing we see here in the example is this instruction here, which basically means we need to import or make available for our application. We need to make available this utilities file that we just created, right? So I'm gonna copy that line, and I'm gonna go to the top of the code here, paste it, and I'm just gonna, well, our utilities file is in the same directory. So I'm just going to say ./utilities, and that will make available those functions within my application. So I think that's it. Pretty much we can try, we can test. So let's go again to the country. Now we see here the response from the API. Is a response is 200, and we can see here the available payment methods in Italy, right? So we have some cash payment method, or we have a card payment methods, bank redirect, remember, right? So we have available these different payment methods. What we can try to do is create a payment using this cash payment method in Italy. So yeah, let's try to do that. So I have already this other function prepared. So let me comment this, and we are gonna write the code here. And again, we already have here some documentation, right? So we have the create payment method, create payment endpoint, which you can find again in our collect, in the collect section, which is our collect platform. So the endpoint will be just slash payments, right? So we to actually create a payment, you need a few fields or few parameters, such as the amount or the currencies and so on. Remember, each payment method has its own required fields, which you can check with the API. You can check which are the required fields for a specific payment method. In this case, let me just copy an example that I already have prepared. So basically, we're doing the same, right? We are calling the make request a function that is part of our utilities file, and we are actually targeting the payments endpoint. In this case, we do have to send some parameters, as I was saying, the amount for the payment that we're creating, the currency, and the payment method itself. So we wanted to get or to use the payment method in Italy. So let's check the information. So the payment method is this one, IT_PS_cash. So let me put it here. And the currency supported here are euros and US dollars. So let's try euros. And let's make a payment for 230. And I think that's it. I'm just gonna save. And let's try to make that payment. Payment. Okay, so we made the payment, we created the payment. You can see here the response code, which is 200 again. You can also see the payment token that was created by the API. The amount was 230 euros in Italy. And the status of this payment is active because this is a cash payment method. So your customer has to go to a store and actually pay with cash. And then when that happens, the store will let us know and we will close or complete this payment. But for now, it is just in active status. I can copy this token. We can go to the client portal and look for this payment actually that we just created. If we go to the collect platform again, then payments, we can see here the payment for 200 euros, which is active. The user still has to go pay. It's cash, and I can see more details here. And if I try to find that token using the browser, it's the token is here, right? So I'm sure this is the exact payment that I created. So just a bit, for instance, if you use some other, just to show an error, if you use a different currency that is not supported, for instance, the Honduras currency that I had before, and I save, and I try to create a payment like that, we get an error, and then the error is currency not supported, right? Because the payment method didn't support this type of currency. Okay, so I think that's pretty much everything I wanted to show you guys. Basically, what we did was we created a new file, utilities file, where we specified our access key, secret keys, and we are basically making sure the request has these headers, the salt, the timestamp that you are generating here in your application. And you send us that to Rapid server so that we can regenerate the signature. And basically the signature is generated based on a formula, concatenation of the different parameters that you have, hashing that string, and then pretty much that's it. And then we imported that file into our application here. And with that, we just called the API using that make request function, making sure, well, the parameters are correct, like the endpoints, the parameters in the endpoints, as well as the fields required by the endpoint as well, right? So yeah, I think that's pretty much. I hope it's useful and you go try it. Just need to create an account, Rapid client portal account, and use these examples, and that's it. This code, by the way, should be available in GitHub, in our account in GitHub, so you can also download the code right away and try it.
Cool. Yeah, I was just getting ready to ask you, Isaac, if we were going to have the code on GitHub. So we'll definitely make sure in the description to have a link directly to that GitHub code that Isaac will get put into a library on our repo. So thanks, Isaac. Really, really appreciate it. Never seen that many 200s back to back without any failure. So spot on. It's really good. I appreciate you doing that. And just as a reminder to everyone, community.rapid.net, you know, join the conversation. If you've got questions for Isaac, myself, or anyone, just post them on the community, start a topic. We're happy to answer them. We're happy to engage with you. Docs.rapid.net, all of the files that you saw, the sample code that Isaac used today is within the reference docs on Docs. We also have some use cases and guides. And if you have any other questions and you're not on the community and you're on Twitter, Rapid Payments is our handle. You can do hashtag RapidBytes and be sure and ask us any questions there. Or let us know what you think about the request signatures and how to calculate those, as well as how to get the list country and make a payment, what Isaac demonstrated for us today. So again, thank you, Isaac.
For sure. Thank you.